students. Good morning, everyone. Today we will start English. Okay. The name of the book is Communicate with Cambridge. It's a new book. It's very, very good, and you can improve your learning and writing skill through this. Okay. So the name of the first lesson is The House with the Golden Windows. What's the name of the lesson? The House with the Golden Windows. As the name suggests, the house is having golden windows. So, anybody house having a golden window? No. It's just an imaginary story. Okay. Let us start the lesson. Before starting, I want you to have the books in your hand and a pencil, because you have some difficult words to be learnt in this, and also you should practice. Okay. So I will start the lesson now. Long, long ago in a village in Scotland, a little boy named Stevie lived on a farm. Every day after school and during the weekends, Stevie helped his father in the field and took care of the farm animals. But at the end of each day, when the work was done and the sun began to go down, there came an hour which was all his own. So the first line, long, long ago in a village in Scotland. So what's the name of the village? Scotland. Underline the word Scotland. Okay. Scotland. Scotland. A little boy named Stevie. What's the name of the boy? Stevie. S-T-E-V-I-E. Stevie. Always remember, you have to use the big letter. Okay. The name of the place, and this is the name of a person. Okay. Lived on a farm. He was living on a farm. Every day after school and during the weekends, Stevie helped his father in the field and took care of the farm animals. So what does Stevie used to do every day after finishing his school? I think even you will also do the same. After finishing the school, you used to go home and help your parents in some doing little small works, like just going to a shop, buying something for your parents. But this Stevie, he used to go to the farm and he used to help his father and take care of the farm animals. Farm animals, what are the animals live in the farm? Domestic animals. Cow, dog, pet animals. So he used to take care of the animals. But at the end of each day when the work was done and the sun began to go down. So at the end, usually the sun will go down. Sun go down means sun will not go down. It's called as a sunset. Okay. There came an hour which was all his own. So what he used to do after the sun goes down, during the sunset, he used to finish all the work by that time, and he used to do of his own work. So what he used to do? When this time came, Stevie would often stroll to the top of a hill near his house and look across at another hill a long way away. So what he used to do? He used to stroll. Stevie used to stroll. What do you mean by stroll? S-T-R-O-L-N. Stroll. This word is highlighted here. What is the meaning of stroll? Walk in a slow, relaxed manner, especially for pleasure. So evening, what he used to do? He used to just go for a walk. Who? Stevie. He used to walk slowly and in a relaxed manner. He was just relaxing during that time. That is called as stroll. S-T-R-O-L-L. Remember the pronunciation. Stroll. At the top, to the top of a hill near his house. So there was a hill near his house. He used to stroll to that hill and look across to another hill. So there was one more hill also across to this hill. It was quite a bit a long way. There on this far off hill stood a house. So there was a house on that hill also, with windows shining like gold. So everybody knows that gold is a shining metal. Okay, so he used to stand in this corner of a hill and he used to see one more hill. There he used to see the house with a golden window. As the sun went down, he would sit on that hill. So what he used to do during the sunset, he used to sit on this side of a hill watching this house. He was just very happy, like enjoying the nature. He was just sitting in this on this top of the hill and he was watching one house with a golden window of the house. The windows shone so brightly. Shone. S-H-O-N-E. What do you mean by shone? So, you know the metal shining, isn't it? This is a past tense form of shine. Shine, shone. Past tense form of shine. It is called as shone. S-H-O-N-E. Shone. That they made Stevie blink when he looked at them. So what he used to do, something, images which are just shining, you just blink your eyes, isn't it? What do you mean by blink? Blink is just nothing but the opening and closing of your eyes. See, even this word is being highlighted, blink. And you can see some of the meanings here. Here they are given blink. What is the meaning? Close and open of the eyes quickly. Okay? When he looked at them. After a while, so blink also you can add right here, underline and practice. Blink. After a while, someone would close the shutters and he knew it was the time to go home for supper. So even here, shutters is there. S-H-U-T-T-E-R-S. Shutters. Shutters means it's just the wooden covers of outside the windows. I think even in school you would have seen the windows having the closing and stuff. That is called as shutters. What it is called? Shutters. And he knew it was the time to go home for supper. So every food, whatever you have, you just can't say that I had dinner, I had breakfast, like that. So whichever particular period you have, there is a specific word to be used. So morning when you are coming to school, you have food, isn't it? What do you call? You call it as a breakfast. Afternoon, lunch. Evening or almost evening or night, I mean 7 to 8 o'clock, you have something to eat, isn't it? Before going to bed. You can either call it as supper or dinner. So it was time to go home for this TV, to go home and have supper. And he was just watching that windows, it was just shining and the shutters was and it was the shutters were shining. So he was seeing that shutters or the windows of the shutters and he knew it was almost closing. So he knew he has to go home for supper. One Saturday, Stevie's father told him, "You earn a holiday. Take a day off today and try to learn something good." So it was Saturday. Every week has, isn't it? Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, like that. So it was a Saturday. One Saturday, Stevie's father told him. What did he tell? You earned a holiday. What do you mean by earned a holiday? It's nothing but it is a time to take off now. You want one holiday because all these days you keep on going to school and working everything. So one day I wanted to spend for you. You take a holiday for that. Take a day off. Take a day off means it's your time. You can enjoy yourself. And try to learn something good. Don't waste time. You have to learn something good. Stevie was delighted. What do you mean by delighted? Very pleased. I think last year in third standard also you learned something, the word called pleased. Ramu and the buffalo in that lesson. Ramu was very, very pleased with the beggar, isn't it? So what do you mean by pleased? He felt very happy, pleased, delighted. D-E-L-I-G-H-T-E-D. Delighted. He was very pleased. Why? Because his father gave a off for him. then started off for the house with the golden windows. So what did the Stevie do? He thanked the father because his father said, okay, you can take an off and you can spend your holiday. What did he do? He went to the top of the hill to watch the golden windows. After trudging for a long time, see, even this word has been highlighted. What is that word called? Trudging. T-R-U-D-G-I-N-G. Trudging. Trudging. What do you mean by trudging? Walking slowly with a lot of effort. See, even stroll is also meant for walking. Trudging also walking only. But see the difference here. What do you mean by stroll? It's walk in a slow and relaxed manner. That is called as stroll. But whereas trudging, walking slowly with a lot of effort. He is walking at the same time, he is putting a lot of effort also for a long time. Stevie came to a big hill. As you know, hills are very, very high. So you have to put an effort to walk up on the hill. That is called as trudging. Stevie came to a big hill. At the top was the house he had been searching for. So he saw a house. For what? Because he was very, very eager to see what is that golden window. How the windows are shining like this. So he was searching for that house. Stevie hurried to it. So he was very, very quick. But to his disappointment, it did not have golden windows. So he went and reached that house. He was very, very disappointed. Why? Because there was no window shining like this. Okay. They were made of clear glass. So it was not at all a golden window. It was clear glass like any normal ones. Just like the normal window, even that house was also having the same kind of window. A woman came to the door. To Stevie's surprise, it was Mrs. Campbell. What was the name of that woman? Mrs. Campbell, a friend of his mother's. Whose friend? Stevie's mother's friend was Mrs. MRS. What do you mean by S? MRS. Mrs. Campbell. Campbell. This was the name of that woman who is Stevie's mother's friend. She is a Stevie's mother's friend. He was just surprised to see his mother's friend there. Hello, Stevie. She exclaimed. Exclaimed means she was very, very surprised to see the Stevie there. How nice to see you here. She expressed her feelings. She felt happy. Suppose if anybody comes to your home, you'll feel happy, isn't it? Like the same way, even Stevie's mother's friend, Mrs. Campbell, felt very happy and she was exclaimed and she expressed, how nice to see you here. Did your mother send you for something? See, there is a question mark here. So whenever there is a question mark, it is called as exclamation. You will, later on, you will learn all these things. Now, whenever this is question mark, you have to express differently. You just can't read the sentence like that. You have to express. How you have to express it? Did your mother send you for something? She asked Stevie very kindly. She asked very kindly. To who? To Stevie. Did your mother send you for anything? Hello, Mrs. Campbell. I came for something else. So, Stevie said, hello, Mrs. Campbell, I came for something else. At the end of every day, I see your golden windows from the top of a hill near our farm. Stevie explained. So Stevie started to explain to Mrs. Campbell. My mother didn't send me. I came here for something else. What is that? I was just watching from a hill. There was a window shining. So I came to see that shining window. Stevie explained, and now I have come here to see them, but I find that they are only glass. I came with such an anxious curiosity was there. I was just very curious to know that golden windows, but it was just a glass window. I think you understood till here, children. Now what is your work is just whatever words I said, whatever words you can see on this board, you just underline those words. And please try to write the meanings. Even the meanings are also given here. Okay. You can use your homework books. And from the First you name the lesson, the house with the golden windows, and write down all these words 5 times. How many times? 5 times. Each word has to be written 5 times, and then whichever word has a meaning for that, I'll make you to write the meanings also in your class workbook. For first thing what you have to do is you write down all these words for homework. The first word is golden, windows, spotlight, stevie, stroll, shone, blink, shutters, delighted, Mrs. Campbell, trudging. Okay. In case if you first what you have to do is you take the textbook and read once. Whichever word is very difficult for you to pronounce, underline, and you can contact the subject teachers, concerned teachers, and ask your doubts also. Okay, so you till here you just practice reading, at the same time you have to write these words also. Okay.